Yep, it's that time once again, people. Although it's a bit late, admittedly. It is one of those things where I've been doing a lot of other things and shooting a lot of other videos. And all of a sudden, the old BoomBox Friday came around and I was... how could I put it? Well, caught out, basically. You know, first Friday in February came round, and, I was so busy doing other things and shooting other videos and whatnot that, it crept up on me, and, so this is a bit late, and just like the BoomBox Friday that I done in January, I had a bit of a trouble uploading that one, so hopefully this one will go okay. Let's go over to the BoomBox now, and let's have a good look at it. Okay, it's a small basic box, but overall, as look it says on the screen, it's a nice little BoomBox really. Let's go over to the Panasonic right now. And there it is, people. That is the Panasonic RX C37L. It's a nice little BoomBox really. There we go. And I've forgotten the tape measure. Oh dear. Let me just get a tape measure out, people. It's not going to be the usual big silver one that I usually use. Hold on. Okay, that will have to do. It's a little tape measure. Little tape measure for a little BoomBox. Okay. So there we go. Right, let's go through the controls on this BoomBox, because it does have a few, but just not as many as other BoomBoxes just might have. Okay, we've got a tone control. Okay. See, it says down the bottom there, you've got bass. I'll see if I can get zoom on it, but you know what this camera's like for zoom, people. There we go. You got a bass there and your treble there. So really speaking, with a tone control, it's best if you just put it somewhere halfway in between. And you can see that mark on the control there. So you put it somewhere halfway in between, and you get a bit of both. Balance control. Now this one does have a balance control on it. You've got left for the left speaker and right for the right speaker. Again, put it in the middle and that sets it on zero. So you get a full-on stereo sound. And of course, the all-important volume control. Minimum and maximum. Okay, let's crank it right the way up. Okay, again, it's got that little marker on there for some weird reason. Maybe it's so you can tell how far it is up the volume range. Okay, it's a four-band radio, this one. Okay, we've got FM up the top. And we got long wave, medium wave, which is the same as AM. Or shortwave. It's a four band box, this one. Okay, and then I've done these controls here, and then that leads us on to these ones. Okay, this is the control for the radio. You can either have it on stereo, 1 and 2, or you can have it on mono. Okay. The mono mode is pretty good if you're listening to FM, but it's all a bit sort of crackly and whatnot. You flick it onto onto mono, and it sort of calms things down a bit. But like as it says, it is a mono sound. Okay, and then you put it right the way up to the top. Okay, functions on this one. We got tape, which is right down the bottom there. Put it in the middle there for the radio, and right up top where it says line. What that is, again, if I'll just quickly flick the box around, we have got the line inputs on the back there. Okay, it's your left, that's your right. Okay, nothing special around the back of this one. But as you've noticed, these speakers have got little plugs on them. I'll show you what the little plugs for the speakers are in a minute. Okay, there's the battery compartment there, and there's a power input on the bottom there. Okay, As far as I know, I don't think this one's got a voltage selector on it. No, it does not. No voltage selector. So it is for UK 240 volts only. So there we go. All of the usual controls on the tape deck. We got stop and eject. The all important record button, rewind, fast forward, play, and of course the old pause button. Let's open up the cassette compartment and have a look in there. Again, very basic, but it's there anyway. Okay, got your record and playback head there, your pinch roller, and of course the erase head on this one. So there we go, it's all there. And I don't know if that record erase head on that is a magnet or whether it's AC bias. I'm unsure. Okay. Out of all honesty, if you want a boombox that does good recordings, do get one that's got AC bias and not a magnet, because magnets are a bit pants for erasing tapes. Okay, if you're using normal tapes, but if you put a chrome cassette in a boombox that's only got a magnet for a erasure head, then it's a bit pants. Okay, but I've got a feeling that this one is AC bias. Okay, and the way you can tell is when you press the play button or the tape head comes up, that little record head, the erasure head, stays down there. Okay, you can see everything else moves if I press the stop button. See all that moves. But as you can see, that erasure head stays in one place. The only time that ever pops up is when you want to do a recording or erase a tape, you see. So that's the only time that pops up. So I've got a feeling that this one is AC bias. But having said that, this boombox does not have a tape selection on it. Okay, so I'd seem to think you can only put normal cassettes in this, not chrome or metal. Okay, there's the tuning control there. Again, this is one of these boom boxes where you've got it's tuned with a traditional piece of string. Okay, there'd be a pulley in there, and it comes around the top there, it goes all the way across, round again, and then it disappears down the back, and there would be the tuning device inside there. And as you turn that, it pulls that along, like so. Okay, so there you go. Pulls it all the way along, all the way up either end. So there we go. And that's it. And for some odd reason, I cannot get that right up to the other end. I may have to look into that. So there we go. Yeah, it's not going all the way up to the other end for some reason. Oh well, I might have to look into that. It's only going up to 104, it should go all the way up to 108 on the FM band. It's not going all the way up. So I might have to look into that, see what's gone wrong with that. Again, I don't really use the radio on this boombox. This little boomer is nice for the line input on it. You put the a CD player in the back of it. And yeah, this boombox does go surprisingly loud. You'll be amazed. So there we go. I will have to look into why that's not going right up and down the full range. But there is the band selector. Okay, got FM up the top. Long wave. Medium wave, which is the same as AM. And then short wave down the bottom. When you're on shortwave, this little other tuning control comes into play. That's so you can fine tune the shortwave. Now, interestingly, on this one, it's got an up and a down. Okay, on some boomboxes, that little dial you can just continuously turns around. But on this one, you've got high and low, and that's it. Okay, and you've got a little notch somewhere on there. You can just barely make out that little notch, and it's sort of bang in the middle there. Can you see that little notch, that little cutout just on the control there? That's in the middle there. Okay, let's put that back on FM like so. I'm not going to power this one up because it hasn't got any flashy lights on it or nothing. So even if it was powered up, you wouldn't be able to see anything in action. Those lights there, that's basically when you turn the radio on, all the cassette players running, that one lights up. When you've got the radio on FM and you pick up an FM radio station, that one lights up. And when you're recording something, you press the record button, that one there lights up. Okay? So it is pretty basic, this boombox. But overall, it's a nice little boombox, peoples. Okay? So there we go. It's a neat little boombox, that. If I had to say the size of this, I would say that this was more or less the same size as one of the... That's the first boombox that I ever had. This was not my first boombox. I mean, the first boombox I ever had, that died an ugly death, that. You know, I can't really say what happened to that on camera, but it did die an ugly death. Bit of a slow one as well, so... But I would say that this boombox was about the same size as the first boombox I ever had. And just for the record, the name of the boombox that I had, my first one, was called a Seisho. And yeah, it was alright, you know, it was a little boomer. Right, measurements. 20.5 inch across the top there. I think I've got the zoom on, people. No, I have not got the zoom on. I thought I did have. Right. Pulled that across the top again. 20.5 inch across the top there, or 52 centimetres. Okay. It's a nice little measurement there. Height, we are looking at just under 8 inches, it's about 7.5 actually, 7.5 inches tall then, or with the handle up, we're probably going for around about 9.5 inch, okay, about 9.5 inch with the handle up, and the overall depth of the boom box, again I will say including that bit on the back there because you do have that bit sticking out as extra. I will not measure it from there to there. So we'll measure it from that point there up to the front. And so the overall depth of the boombox is around near on 6 inch. We just might as well call it 6 inch. By the time you get the power cord in the back, because the power cord does tend to stick out a bit, you might as well call that 6.5 inch. Okay? 6.5 or 7 inch. So there it is. Okay, nice little boom box, people. Now then, let's put the aerial up. There we go. Again, it's got one of those antennas on it which just goes on for miles and miles. So there we go. This little boombox, people, it's what's called a three-piece boombox. Now, earlier on, you saw on the back, those speakers had little wires on the back of them. Okay, here is why. If I just reach around the back there, I'm not sure, yeah, I can do it with one hand. Here we go. The speakers come off. Okay, so there it is. They do detach. And that is why I'm trying to do this with one hand. Hold on a minute, people. I cannot get that other one with the little release catch. Right, there we go. As you can see, there's the centre unit, people. Okay, little centre unit. There's one speaker there, and there's the other one there. Okay, so yeah, they do detach the speakers. And yes. So there you go, you can configure it how you want it. So there it is. Okay. What I could do is I could put the speakers underneath the main unit like that. Like so. I could set it up like that if I wanted. There you go. Not quite a Toshiba WX1, but you get the idea. But yeah, so you can configure these as the way you want. And a big bonus with three-piece boxes is, of course, You can put the speakers a bit further apart to get a wider stereo sort of sound effects with it. Okay, so there it is, people. The Panasonic RXC37L with detachable speakers. There it is. That little tweeter in there, that's probably just a little piezo speaker in there. There's a woofer. It's a woof woof woofer. Okay. Again, you've got a little wire on the back there. That, if I turn the back, centre unit around, you got your little speaker connections there and those little plugs just go in there. Okay, and there's obviously one there as well for that speaker. And there it is. Okay, we haven't had that battery compartment open yet, peoples. I'll say we open it up and have a look around in there. Let's open it up. And there it is. Again, it's only a little basic boombox, so it doesn't take that many batteries. Let's have a look around. There you go, that's the C size that go in there. And it takes 6 of them. So there we go. 6 C cells that go inside there. And there it is. That little cutout part there, I suppose that's so you can get your finger in there to pull the batteries out when you want them to remove. And again, same with there, you can get your finger in there to pull the batteries out. So there it is. There's your power input on the back of it. Okay. And your line inputs there. Now, interestingly, I've just noticed on the back of this, it doesn't seem to have a specification plate, people. That is because they've put it, for some weird reason, they've put it on the underside of the boombox. If I turn the front unit around and light it down like that, there is the specification plate, people. I'll try and get a zoom on it, but you know what this camera's like for zoom. That's probably about as good as it's going to get. Now the odd thing is, it doesn't say on there, because on some specification plates it says all the radio bands it can accept as well. It, you know, normally says on there like FM 98 to 108. Medium wave, which would be between this and that and the other. Long wave and short wave. But on this one, it doesn't. It just says what the power is. 240 volts, 50 hertz, 14 watts. This little boomer takes. Actually, I've got that wrong, people. I said this took C-size batteries. It actually takes D-cells. Okay. So I actually got that wrong. Wow. So there's 6 D-size batteries in that, which equates to 9 volts. I actually thought when I looked around the back there that this was C batteries. Yeah, so that does actually take D-cells. So there it is, people. I'm going to wrap this up now and put the back cover back on. We'll go for 21 minutes. Okay. See if I can get the battery compartment back on. There we go. So there we go. Let's put the speakers back on. Like so, you offer them up like that. You make sure that the little guide matches up. And then they should just slide all the way down. There you go, that's that one attached. And then you just line that one up all the way down it goes. And it's attached. And if we pick the boombox up, you can see once again, it is a one-piece boombox. Okay. So there it is. And then, when you just go around the back, You just put the wires back in like so. Try and make it as neat and tidy as possible. I mean, I've seen people walking down the street with these boom boxes before now, and all the wires are hanging down on the back and it just looks plain horrible. Okay, so always make your speaker wires look neat and tidy. So there you go. It's nice and wound around on there. You've got no wires hanging down or nothing like that. You don't want that happening. Neat and tidy and smartly presented, of course. There you go. So there it is, people. That was BoomBox Friday for February 2012, although being it a bit late. Okay, I'm sorry about it, people, but really the first Friday of this month really did creep up on me and I didn't notice. Okay, so that was the Panasonic RXC37L. Okay then, people, thanks for watching.